Growth hormone is another hormone that is created under the influence of the hypothalamus and the anterior pituitary. So the hypothalamus is going to secrete, and here's the hypothalamus up here, is going to secrete two factors. It's going to either secrete growth hormone releasing hormone, which will come into the anterior pituitary, and then the anterior pituitary makes growth hormone, which acts on all kinds of tissues in the body, or the hypothalamus will release growth hormone inhibiting hormone, also known as somatostatin, and that simply inhibits the release of growth hormone from the anterior pituitary. Anterior pituitary, if it's stimulated, makes growth hormone. And again, that is going to act on lots of different tissues, but its main function of growth hormone is going to be on the liver. The liver is then going to synthesize another peptide called insulin-like growth factor 1, also known as IGF-1. IGF-1 then, secreted from the liver, acts on bones, acts on muscle, acts on lots of other tissues to increase the mitotic rate and increase growth of those tissues. Growth hormone acting, again, hypothalamus to anterior pituitary, growth hormone to the liver, and then IGF-1 going out and affecting all kinds of other tissues in the body. And that is the main way that growth hormone can stimulate growth. There's one more hormone that I want to tell you about because it's a hormone and it's made, and it's out there in circulation, but we don't know that much about it in humans, and that is melanocyte-stimulating hormone. So it's another hypothalamus anterior pituitary regulated hormone. So when the hypothalamus secretes adrenocorticotropic hormone into the anterior pituitary here, it also stimulates the formation and secretion of melanocyte-stimulating hormone. So hypothalamus makes adrenocorticotropic hormone. Adrenocorticotropic hormone also stimulates the production of MSH, or melanocyte-stimulating hormone, from the anterior pituitary. Its function is unclear in humans. We're not really sure what it does. But if there is an over-secretion of melanocyte-stimulating hormone, it will act on the melanocytes of your skin, and the result is a hyperpigmentation. And so that is something of which to be aware, but I'm not really sure that it's that relevant in humans. So in summary, what I'd like you to know is how does growth hormone stimulate growth? What are the two factors that are secreted by the hypothalamus that regulate the release of growth hormone, and then once growth hormone is secreted by the anterior pituitary, where does it act, and then what are the downstream effects of growth hormone secretion? If you understand those things, then you're ready for the assessment.